this is an alternative application for an arch support, particularly where you don't want the rear foot being affected like it is in the other arch support technique that we will generally do. This one is really focusing on resisting that foot lengthening out both in a longitudinal direction as well as our transverse arch. And so it can be, you know, useful, as I say, on some of our dancers, for example, where we're, you know, perhaps not wanting to increase their inversion, or which potentially may increase risk of an inversion injury of the ankle. Although some of the preliminary evidence on our other arch support technique has suggested that time to stabilization is actually exactly the same with and without. So although we're getting nice changes in the arch height and we're creating some external resistance to them, flattening out, so we're taking some load off those structures that would normally do it, our plantar fascia, flexor hallucis longus, tib post, tib ant, soleus, etc., that we're actually not making them any more at risk of going over. But this one is a nice alternative if you are concerned, or if it is somebody who has, say, had recurrent ankle sprains. So what we're going to do is start on this lateral side and create almost like a figure eight around the foot. So we're going to start laterally, aiming on an angle down the foot. We don't want to be too transverse, or we'll lose that shortening longitudinally. We're going to aim in towards the inside of the heel, keeping our tension on. We're going to just sweep around and then come up and bring the big toe around as well. So we're creating a horizontal flexion of our metatarsals and tarsals to increase that transverse arch, as well as getting a force vector longitudinally to resist flattening of our medial and lateral longitudinal arches. So we can see how we've created this concavity in the bottom of the foot and a convexity over the top, and we've shortened both longitudinally and transversely. So now there's resistance to that foot lengthening out longitudinally as well as flattening out transversely. So we can take some load off those structures. The foot can still get there. Movement is really important both for dissipating load, but also for adapting or accommodating to ground surfaces, uneven ground surfaces, and so on. But this will give us a nice deceleration and load absorption into more of a pronated position, and then actively resupinate to give us that nice stable lever for push off. You can also see we get this spongy sort of soft tissue offload effect occurring around the heel pad. So if somebody has heel pad pain or perhaps plantar fasciitis, this may also give some pain relief by creating that soft tissue offload in that region as well.